called all of his wise men to tell the dream, and his wise men all they failed to reveal the dream, and king ordered to kill them all. So to kill them all, the soldiers of king, when he went to Daniel asked what is the reason why king wanted to kill. He meekly, softly he asked, and he heard all things. And Daniel, he went to the king and he asked time so that he can tell the dream. And Daniel prayed to God, and God revealed the dream to Daniel. So Daniel, he was able to tell the dream to the king, and king was happy. And the same time, king, how he ordered to kill all the wise men, they also saved, because Daniel told to not to kill the wise men, and all the wise men they lived or they survived. And the dream was a statue. We all know, though, the statue, that it has four parts, and four different metal was there. The first, the head was gold, then the breast was silver, then bronze, then leg was iron. And Daniel described the dream to king, you are the head, and you have many wealth, you have many riches, and you are the head, and you are most powerful, and you are most strong. So king was happy. And after the king, there will be a little lower strong kingdom will come, and then another kingdom will come, then another kingdom will come. So this is where Daniel described the dream. And after a few years, king, he made a statue of gold. So because Daniel interpreted the dream that king was the head, the gold, so he made a complete statue with gold, and he wanted to dedicate it, and he set up it in the plain of Dura. In the Dura province he set up it, and he called all the leaders, all the princes, all the principals of his kingdom to worship it. So all the princes, all the leaders, they gathered and they worshiped it. But three people were found there, the three friends of Daniel. Somehow Daniel was not there. And the three people, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah, they called Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. So they were there, but they didn't worship the statue. So they are accused for not to worshiping the image. And king ordered them, so you come. They went to king, and king gave them another opportunity to worship. But they replied, king, we will not worship your statue, we will not bow down to your statue. And king threatened them by telling, if you do not worship my statue, if you do not bow to my statue, then you will be killed, or you will be thrown in the fire. So Bible says, Isaiah chapter 41 verse 10, Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you, I will help you, I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. So God promised to us that God will be with us and God will help us. So we should not fear. So Bible tells you should not fear. And we see the three friends, Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego, they didn't fear there. So they replied the king, we will not do. Another verse, if we see Isaiah 43 verse 2, it says, when you pass through the water, I will be with you, and through the rivers, they shall not overwhelm you. When you walk through a fire, you shall not be burned, and the flame shall not consume you. So when you will walk through the fire, you shall not be burned. So I think they remembered the word of God. So God will be with you. And they didn't agree to the king to worship the statue. So Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego replied to the king, we will not bow to your statue. And David said in Psalms chapter 23 verse 4, he says, even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. So when I will walk through the shadow of the valley of the death, I will not fear. So we see the three friends of Daniel, they didn't fear to the king and they didn't worship. And how they reply to the king, if we see Daniel chapter 3 verse 16, 17, 18, they replied, Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego answered and said to the king, O Nebuchadnezzar, we are not careful to answer thee in this matter. So king told them, if you do not worship, you will be thrown in the fire, and there is no one who can save you from my hand. And the three friends of Daniel, they are replying, we no need to answer you, because if it is be, so our God whom we serve is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace, and he will deliver us out of thine hand, O king. So God is able to deliver us from the fire. God is able to save us from your hand. And verse 18 says, but if not, so God is able to save us, but if he not save us, after that also we will not worship your image. So be it known unto thee, O king, that we will not serve thy gods. It will be small gods. So we will not serve your God, nor worship the golden image which thou hast set up. So the three friends of Daniel, they didn't bow to the image or statue, and they are cast into the fire. And Habakkuk chapter 2 verse 4 says, the righteous shall be lived by faith. So faith is very important, and to depending on God is very important. Habakkuk 2:4, behold, if we see the last line, last sentence, but the just shall live by his faith. And John 3:16 says, if we have faith on Jesus, we will have the eternal life, and God can save us. Sometimes God allow the sorrow, suffering, pain in our life, but He saves us. And if we have faith, He will save us. So God saved the three friends of Daniel. And another story is it is found in Daniel 6. Daniel, he was cast in the lion's den. The colleagues of Daniel, they made an law because they hated Daniel, and they made a law through the king. We find in Daniel chapter 6, 5, 7, because Daniel was their boss, and they were not loving Daniel, and they were thinking how to move him, Daniel, or how to kill him, or how he will not the leader of us. So they planned to how they can remove him, and they planned they will make a rule: nobody will worship God, because they said we will not find any guilt in him. Only we can find the guilt with the law of God. So they said, this man, we shall not find any occasion against this Daniel, except we find it against him concerning the law of his God. So Daniel, he was very concerned to obey his Lord, to obey the law of God. And the people, they know they will not find any guilt with them. So they made a plan. Verse 7, all the presidents of the kingdom, the governors and the princes, the counselors and the captains have consulted together to establish a royal status, to make a firm decree that whosoever shall ask a petition of any god or man for 30 days, save of thee, O king, he shall be cast into the den of lion. So they made a rule, who will worship any god or any man for 30 days, he will be cast into the lion's den. And here we see the Satan, how he brings the problem. When we will worship the Lord, the Satan will bring the problem. When we will obey the law of God, then Satan will bring the problem. So this is the will of Satan, how he can destroy the law of God, how he can move us from the God. Wednesday evening, someone sent me a picture in my messenger, and it is written here, every Sunday is now designated National Day of Prayer. Anyone who refuses to observe Sunday will be rebaptized, waterboarded, or sent to jail for 10 years. So I try to search in the internet, is it true or false? But I didn't find like this statement anywhere in the internet. So I don't know, is it true or fake? Maybe someone edited. Again, it can be true, I don't know. But it says the Sunday law, about the Sunday law. And Bible tells us the mark of the beast, we all know. And we all know the what is the seal of God and what is the mark of the beast. Both are opposite to one another. And God says, I told the future. In Isaiah chapter 46 verse 10, God says, I tell the future. And we will see in the Bible everywhere God tells the future, and every prophecy fulfilled, and it is also one of the prophecy in the Bible. So we believe, I believe it will be fulfilled, but when it will be fulfilled, how it will be fulfilled, I don't know. If we see in Revelation chapter 13 verse 15, 16, 17, it says, who will not worship the image of the beast should be killed. So who will not worship the image of the beast should be killed. And 16 says, also it causes all boats, or both small and great, both rich and poor, both free and slave, to be marked on the right hand and on the forehead, so that no one can buy or sell unless he has the mark that is the name of the beast or the number of his name. So Bible tells all should take the mark of the beast, and if they do not receive, then they will not be able to buy or sell. And somehow if we see in the present world, it is starting somehow. So the idea of Satan to move the people from the law of God, from the God, and God, he allow us to go through the danger, go through the fire, like how the three friends of Daniel, they were cast into the fire. So this is where God allow us, but at the same time we see God, he saves us from the danger also. So if we believe in God, of course the suffering, the pain will come, but if we depend on him, he will save us. And we know the story of Daniel. He was thrown in the lion's den, and God saved him. So somehow Daniel also, he saved by God. And in this three story we see, because of the faith of Daniel, because of his word, because of his righteousness, the other people, other wise men of the king, they saved. And we see another two stories, God allows the suffering to us, and if we depend on him, he will save us. And Bible is the true word of God, and we see all the promises, all the prophecies is fulfilling, so we can depend on God more and more. Though the problem comes, he will rescue us. So this is message I want to share in this morning. I'd like to thank you so much for listening to me. Thank you.